Welcome to antenna and wave propagation playlist. Here in this session, I'll be going to explain polarization measurement. So first of all, before I explain how to have a measurement of polarization, let us try to understand what is that basic term which we want to measure. So polarization is orientation of electric field. There are basically three types of polarization: linear polarization, and in linear there will be two other category, horizontal and vertical polarization. Second is circular polarization, and even in circular there are two categories, left hand circular polarization and right hand circular polarization. And third is elliptical polarization, and even that is having two categories, left hand elliptical circular polarization and right hand elliptical circular polarization. So basically there are three major category of polarization, which is what I'll be going to explain you how we can have a measurement of this polarization. And for that, I'll be explaining you one very simple experimental setup. And by having that setup, we can easily have measurement of polarization. So first of all, one should know polarization is orientation of electric field. So ultimately, we are dealt with to measure orientation of electric field. If orientation of electric field is vertical, then we can say signal is linearly polarized by vertical polarization. If orientation of electric field is horizontal, then we can say signal is linearly horizontally polarized. If orientation of electric field is rotating in clockwise direction, and in that case, we can say that polarization is circular polarization with right hand circular polarization. If orientation of electric field revolves with same magnitude in anticlockwise direction, in that case, one can say it is left hand circular polarization. And if orientation of electric field is revolving by different magnitudes on two axes, in that case it could be elliptical polarization. So by having this three method, by having a measurement of polarization, we can justify what kind of signal that we are sending from antenna. So here, to understand that, I have shown one experimental setup by which one can measure polarization. Now see what we are doing here. First of all, here we have transmitting antenna, that is antenna under test, and we don't move position of this antenna under test, it is fixed. And we have receiving antenna, and that should be linear antenna. So we should have linearly polarized antenna. Dipole is linearly polarized antenna. So as a receiving antenna, I have kept dipole antenna here. Now see what we will be doing. We will be rotating this dipole antenna by this angle phi. So when you rotate angle, when you rotate this by angle phi like this, we will be rotating this by like this. So by rotating this by angle phi, we can be able to measure radiation by antenna under test. And based on observation of what kind of radiation which we are receiving, we can be able to say like what kind of polarization will be there. Like see, first of all, try to understand what is that which we will be doing here. Here we have transmitting antenna, that is antenna under test, and here we have receiving antenna, that is dipole antenna. Now what we do is we send signal from transmitting antenna and we receive signal from linearly polarized dipole antenna. Now by revolving this antenna with angle psi, we will be measuring field at dipole antenna. So at different angle psi, we will be measuring electric field of dipole antenna. And first we will be plotting that field which we receive at dipole antenna. And by observing that field, we can be able to say what kind of polarization which is there at antenna under test. So here AUT is transmitting antenna, receiving antenna is linearly polarized. Here we have took dipole. Dipole is rotated in plane of polarization. Like this, I have explained this. Electric field of dipole is recorded and plotted with respect to sign. Now, I'll explain first. Like, see, in first case, what is happening is, I am recording electric field like this. So, what I have done is, I have measured electric field, and from angle 0, 90, 180 and 270 degree, I have recorded electric field and I have plotted it over here. In second case, when I was recording that electric field, I have seen that electric field was something like this. And in third case, when I have recorded electric field of AUT, then that electric field, that was something like this. So now, based on this radiation, we need to justify what kind of polarization is this. So here one can see dipole antenna pattern, that is this. Dipole antenna pattern, that is this. And received antenna pattern, that is even similar. So it means this is what vertically polarized signal. So one can say this is linearly vertically polarized signal. So linear polarization, that is what we are observing for this antenna under test. Now for this case of radiation measurement, one can see if I trace out a trajectory of electric field, then one can observe this will be the trajectory. Now, this is what having magnitude horizontally, it is, let us say it is EA, and vertically that magnitude is EB. So ultimately here EA is smaller than EB. It means this polarization of AUT, that has to be elliptically polarized. So this is what the case, which is what elliptical polarization case. And in third case, you can observe electric field is exactly similar by magnitude in all direction. So for this case, we can say this is what circular polarization. So ultimately, by this shape of receiving pattern, we can say transmitting antenna is linearly polarized. By this shape of radiation pattern at received antenna, one can say this is what transmitting antenna, that should be elliptically polarized. In that case, we should be able to measure this shape of pattern. And if pattern is having equal magnitude at receiving antenna in all direction, then one can say that that AUT, which is what transmitting antenna, that has to be circular polarized antenna. So here, what exactly the case which we are doing? We are trying to measure like what kind of polarization that is happening by having received signals pattern. Now why that is happening, first of all, that one should know. Like, see, when you talk about antenna, let us consider this is antenna and this is second antenna. Now let us consider this is transmitting antenna and this is receiving antenna. Now what happens if, now orientation of both antenna is exactly same right now. Now if I say my transmitting antenna, this antenna, that is vertically polarized antenna. And if my receiving antenna, this is this, which is even vertically polarized antenna. So what will happen? Electromagnetic wave radiated by this antenna, that will go like this. So its pattern will be vertical like this, and it will get received at receiving antenna. So here what happens, this, because of this antenna is vertically polarized, it will be receiving maximum signal. So if vertical polarized antenna sends signal to vertical polarized antenna with same orientation of antenna, in that case receiving antenna will receive maximum signal. Now right now both antenna are vertically polarized antenna, but now I am keeping orientation of this antenna like this, which is perpendicular to this. Now if this antenna that is sending vertically polarized signal like this, and this is what antenna which is vertical and polarized antenna, but it is oriented horizontally. So right now you will be observing this antenna will receive minimum signal. So ultimately when you have a measurement, you should be using receiving antenna to be linearly polarized, so that one can understand like what could be the polarization which is there with transmitting antenna. So here in case of this AUT to be linearly polarized, if you revolve this antenna like this, you'll be finding at this angle which is 90 degree, at this angle which is 90 degree with respect to initial angle, there will be no received signal. And again when it is oriented like this, it will receive signal, and again when you revolve like this, it will not receive signal. And here I have shown this angle to be 90 degree here, where maxima is there. So ultimately initial orientation was 90 degree like this. But if you consider, in case of this is what initial angle 90 degree, then this has to be 0 degree, and this has to be 270 degree, and this has to be 180 degree. See, that is how one can measure this. So for linear polarization that happens. But for elliptical polarization, when we see received radiation pattern, then in one axis you will be finding little less magnitude is received, and in second axis you will be finding little more magnitude is received. So based on that one can say whether this is elliptical polarization or not. And for a case of circular polarization, you will be receiving equal magnitude in all direction. So based on magnitude one can say this is what circular polarization. So this is what the exact thing which we are doing in measurement of polarization. Thank you so much for watching this video. You can suggest me those videos which is required to complete antenna and wave propagation. If I have knowledge based on your queries, definitely I will try to sort out those queries by placing video here. Thank you so much for watching this video.